choke from Reinier to Relive. Is this the beginning of the end? Yes, it is.
Just dominance.
This could be it now. I think this is it.
I beat the welterweight champ. I beat the middleweight champ. I beat the light heavyweight champ. What's next? Heavyweight, guys, come on. Let me fight Malakin. Let me fight Bular in the same night. I'll finish these guys in the same night. Let's go.
In one championship history, only three men have simultaneously held world titles in two weight classes. Reinier de Ridder is the last one standing.
Reinier de Ridder, he is phenomenal, amazing, two division. World champion.
A perfect 15-0 in MMA. The one middleweight and light heavyweight world champion has finished all but one of his foes. The Dutch Knight's dominance can be traced to his early start in martial arts.
I started off with judo at age 5. I had a lot of fun there, a lot of competitions. There's boxes full at my dad's house with medals and trophies. I moved places to start my studies as a physio. I was looking for another judo gym, but couldn't really find a good one. Then I heard of BJJ, so I went to a gym here in Breda, trained here the first time with a couple of guys. I basically choked everybody out, threw them around, and I said, this stuff does not work. Somebody told me, you went to the wrong jiu-jitsu gym. You should come with me to another one. And so I went. When I rolled, there were a bunch of small guys, like blue belts, 70 kilos, 75 kilos. And they would choke me out, and I was like, what the f*** is this? I need to learn this stuff right now. So from there, I fell in love with jiu-jitsu.
This man is a whole different breed of martial arts animal.
I got the silver medal in the European Jiu-Jitsu Championships 3 times. I was very frustrated with the way it all went down. In the finals, every time a Brazilian guy would just basically ran away for the entire match. I was just trying to win on points. Referee advantage. So I said, I need a real fight. I need to be able to punch somebody in the face if I need to. And that was the first amateur fight I took. After the first amateur fight, I went pro right away. And the rest is history, I guess.
De Ridder scored 9 consecutive finishes before signing with one in 2019. He debuted in the circle against Chinese star Fan Rong, who entered with a 12-fight winning streak.
Fan Rong could be in trouble. Is this the beginning of the end? Yes, it is. It's good night, Irene. Reinier de Ridder puts Fan Rong to sleep.
He actually told me if he wasn't able to get the back, he would look to the darts. And he actually did it, exactly what he said.
After a TKO win over Gilberto Galvao, de Ridder defeated Leandro Otitis and secured a shot at 2-division-1 world champion, Ong Lan Sung.
I want to wish Leandro Otitis and Reinier de Ridder good luck, and may the best man win.
Oh! Oh, look at that body lock takedown. So strong, coming from RDR.
And there's a right hand down the tube. De Ridder looks for a crossing elbow just to the hairline of Otitis, now ties him up.
That elbow landed big time.
Angla, are you ready? Keep that belt shining, because I'm coming for it. Let's go!
And at one, inside the Matrix, de Ridder shocked the world.
Reinier de Ridder sets the choke again, trying to crush the chin of Angla.
Oh, it's sliding underneath the chin.
Is it gonna happen? Oh my word! He promised victory. He gets victory. Reinier de Ridder does what many thought impossible.
But wanting more than middleweight gold, de Ridder targeted Ong Lan Sung's one light heavyweight world title 6 months later.
What dominance from RDR on the ground today. He's mounted Ong Lan more times than a pommel horse.
It's just a masterclass from Reinier de Ridder, taking this match exactly where he wanted to.
And the only man ever to take world titles from another man across 2 different weight divisions.
Then, last February, the Dutchman defended his one middleweight world title against welterweight king Cameron Abasov.
And Cameron's face is a horror story. It is red, the crimson is flowing. Abasov has walked into a nightmare that he cannot wake up from. Too easy. Too easy. Abasov was never in this match.
On the 22nd of July, De Ridder must fight off another former ONE World Champion, top middleweight contender, Vitaly Bigdash.
The belt is not a burden. It's a nice tool to get a chance to face everyone, and I want a piece of everybody. Bigdash's biggest weakness is his mind. I want to show that I can break him.
Will the undefeated Dutchman retain his middleweight gold and remain a two-division king? Find out at 1:159.